Welcome to the vlog.
Season 3.
Welcome to the vlog.
Monday morning was extra special because after my workout, I went to my first ever physio appointment. It was really, really cool, and I got some treatments done on my leg. We basically confirmed that there was a shin splint going on.
Hello, I got back from physio, and that was just such a great experience. Good news first, she basically was like, "You did all the right things. You'll be able to run the marathon. And I just have to make sure that I keep doing the cross training, and then when I go back into running, like easing into it, trying to run more trails around the track just to like reduce the amount of cement running that I'm doing, and then also just doing some more walking and running together." Which, again, going back to taking the ego out of training, I think I always felt like, oh, you're weak if you walk when you're doing a run, like you're not fit. And I don't know why I have to prove that I'm fit. It doesn't matter. Ultimately, like, I just need to like train in a way that is conducive to getting like a good result and keeping my body healthy. So who cares? I shouldn't be concerned about that when I'm like training to the point of injury. You know what I mean?
Just another classic Monday, work from home. During lunch, I decorated some cookies, did some more work, and then I had a protein shake before going out on a ride. It's the first outdoor ride of the season. I was so excited. We just ended up doing laps of Stanley Park.
How are you feeling?
I'm in bad shape.
I always forget how hard the hill up Prospect Point is, but I felt pretty strong doing it. I think running translates to good cardio just on the bike as well, which is nice. And then we got home and had some yummy pizza. All of them turned out really well. The dough was just really fabulous. And then Molly helped me decorate some of the cookies for Easter. Aren't they looking very cute?
Hello, I've got my hair all oiled before I go to bed. I will be getting up very early to go on a 2-hour cycle on the bike, so fun-ish. It's like 8:40, but I'm gonna try and make myself go to bed. Obviously, tomorrow's gonna be a bit of an early... It's gonna be a rough wake-up, to be honest, but... It'll be fine. Hello, it's 4:38 a.m. I've been riding for a bit. Feeling pretty good. Gonna be riding until like 6 a.m. Okay, 1 hour in, I probably have 36 minutes left. Currently, I've gone 28.8 kilometers. Honestly, the only reason I want to stop this run is because I'm really excited to shower today and wash my hair. So that'll be good. I'm done. Oh, fuck. Oh my God, this training is kicking. This training like is always kicking my ass. Apparently, I did 44 kilometers. That's pretty good. I'm halfway through my leg workout. Oh my God. I'm fucking dying right now. My legs, even sitting down, hurts. My legs are so exhausted. But as long as I get through the session, I'll be happy. I'm lifting lighter to compensate for the fact that I am fucking tired. And I'm okay with that. I just need to get through it.
I just could not catch a break that morning. I was doing the most, as usual.
I'm in a good mood. I'm definitely exhausted, like, physically. I feel, like, pretty alert, but my body just feels, like, very, very worn out today, which is, like, very self-explanatory. I realized in the past 3 days, I've ridden 174 kilometers, and I've done 2 strength workouts. I don't know, doing a lot of movement, trying to stay active for next week when I can run again.
It was just an average day. I had lunch, I saw a corgi, but I couldn't catch it in the camera, and then came back.
I am done work and I came home. I have some time for my Brazilian appointment and book club, so I'm gonna actually go to the running store on Denman and hopefully find some new shoes. We'll see. I just felt like work went by super, super slowly, which was frustrating. I feel just like so drained because of that. So I'm happy that it's over and that I have a nice evening planned.
I ordered a new shoe. It's going to be here on Tuesday in the right size. And then I walked over to downtown. In the end, I ended up doing my book club with Angela and George. That was really fun. And then, oh, Kai Kai also bought us so much food. So nice of him.
Hello, it is 4:30. I am on the bike. No workout with George today, so this gets to be a bit longer. My theory is that if I'm very tired today, I'll sleep on the flight. Who knows, but
That's the goal.
I'm an hour into training. It's going well. I really have an hour left. Honestly, I'm feeling kind of nervous. I feel like travel is so annoying and there's so many things that can go wrong. I'm trying to think about it too much, but it's like on my mind.
Okay, hi. Sorry, I did not update the end of that ride because basically right towards the end, I was getting all these updates from the airline being like, it's being changed. And then it just got canceled. So that's why I was getting all anxious. And then I fucking had to stay on hold with like Expedia and then through Delta. And then I ended up having a really, really, really nice attendant at Delta who helped me rebook a flight. I'll be leaving tomorrow at 6 a.m. So no more red eye. And I go through Calgary to get to Nashville. I'm just relieved to have gotten a flight in the first place. You know what I mean? I'm getting there like basically 2 hours later than I was supposed to. And honestly, it works out because I arrive like closer to when Georgia lands. And otherwise I was just gonna have to like either leave on my own or wait for her at the airport. So I'm in a good mood, like I'm happy. Yeah, I honestly just feel like so much more relaxed knowing I don't have to like rush from work to my grandparents for dinner and then like also go and get my luggage. Like I just feel very good right now.
I didn't film much at work today. I was very tired. Just a series of selfies at me at the office and walking outside, but it was a good day. And then in the evening, of course, I went to hang out with my grandparents and had dinner. Then I came home and edited.
I can't be fucked. Take the mask off. I'm so sorry. I look like a fucking idiot. I did a little bit of editing, so I wouldn't have it all to do in Nashville. I'm so tired. Today was a very tiring day. It's okay. It's almost over, but I'm excited to just be done. And to wake up at 3:30 this morning for my flight, which I'm actually excited about. I'm not excited about having to pay for a fucking Uber, but that's okay.
Look at me all up in the atom for my flight. Obviously very early, but I was still super, super excited. And we got to the airport and boarded our flight, and then our layover was kind of chaotic.
We just had the most stressful time going through security. My backpack got stopped. It was only like one of them with my shoes. So I'm just standing there shoeless while I have to wait. And there was like 8 bags in front of me and there's only 2 people looking through them. And one of the people going through the bags was very thorough. It took so long. And then she made it go through security in like 2 different segments. We made it. We were running. We were in our Rory era. How you feeling?
I'm literally sweating. I had to chug a liter of water and then run. And now it's just coming out.
Okay, obviously I had an airport ginger ale and then we landed in Nashville and this is the place. It's kind of like a studio apartment setup. It's very cute and I thought it was like a great space and like a good place for us to be. We were like in the middle of downtown, which was very useful, but yeah, and the bathroom was huge also. Look at that.
Hello, we're about to go for drinks. You have the fits for the day.
It's not serving that country, but
no.
It's a semi-split.
It's a semi-country split. I don't know if the camera can. Oh, the camera picks it up. Miranda went to look out the window and slammed her. I can't see
that. We went out to get groceries, and that was fun just being able to explore Nashville. I had my little protein shake and a little bit of bite to eat before we went out for the first night. We went to this little restaurant first. We just got a little drink there. It was through like a food hall, which was super cool. We all committed to having tequila the whole weekend, so I had a little tequila drink and so did they. It was very yummy. Then it was time for us to go to the hockey game. It was very fun. Oh my gosh, like there's so much spirit. Like obviously I've been to a Canucks game before, but like this is a bit different. Like everybody's a lot more lively than they are back home.
I hope to not be hungover tomorrow. I'm definitely tired.
Hello, we are gonna be going to our
drive our appointment soon. My hair is like disgustingly greasy. I need to get it. I'm very excited to get it done. I've never had like a drive our appointment before, so that'll be fine.
I had a minor headache this morning, but overall not doing too badly in terms of hangover.
So we went to our drive our appointment. That was very exciting. It was super nice to get like our hair washed and like styled like that. I was it was just special. Like, it's obviously like really nice when anybody ever does your hair. We walked in round in the area near our hair salon, and we went into so many little boutiques. That's what I've been really liking about Nashville. There's all these little stores with such cool clothes. Also, things are very expensive though. Like, everything in the store, the pink store, was like $300. And then we went to Frothy Monkey. This is like my favorite place in Nashville. I'm absolutely obsessed with it. I have no reason to be obsessed with it. I just am. I kind of want their merch. I really like it. And then we went to Reese Witherspoon's store. And then we walked around. This place had like a lot of bride memorabilia or whatever. And then we went to this little cereal store. We didn't buy anything, but it was still cool.
What is it? One drink for function, one drink for hydration, and then one drink for fun.
We chilled at the apartment for a while, and I had a little bite to eat.
We're about to go to Dolly's restaurant, and we're very excited. Where's Georgia?
There she is.
Little busted because I definitely still have like makeup from last night on, but it's okay. I'm gonna give you guys a little recap on what happened last night. So Miranda's phone got stolen. The phone.
She's like, so phone got stolen.
It ended up okay because we're gonna go get a new one today. She's being a very big trooper about it. Me and Georgia were talking about how if it had been one of us, we would have fully thrown a tantrum and like been in like a horrible mood. Literally, I would have been the foulest person on the trip. Yeah. So Miranda's an angel. She's handling it so well. So we're going to go to the Apple store today to get her a new phone. We also had another fallen, a less significant fallen soldier. The purse did break. It's fine. It's thrifted, but I was a little sad. It is an Italian leather purse. So maybe this is bad, but I kind of want to get super glue and like just super glue it back on. I'm sorry if there's any purse makers watching that are offended by this. That's the tea. That's what we're just going to go get Miranda's phone, and then we're going to go for brunch later.
Fire away!
honestly a little bit busted this morning. Shake Shack happened, but we were very tired. We enjoyed the sun for a bit before retreating back to the apartment.
We have been having our relaxing afternoon. We're all a little tired and sleep deprived, so just had some rest, and we're gonna rally for the final night.
We made it out, y'all. Disassociation station is leaving.
Okay, we were absolutely determined to have a good night. It was night three. We were absolutely not gonna just get out of it. Also, look at my outfit. So cute. Little denim moment. We went to Miranda Lambert's restaurant. That was fun. And then we went back to our regular place. This is the place we've been going to every single night. Jason's was fun. Georgia learned how to line dance from an Irish guy. And we just chilled out. It was very fun. I got these sunglasses. Cute.
End of the day the way we started.
Shake, shake.
And then I came home and I had to edit all of this wonderful video that you're watching. So fun. We've all gotten back safely, which is great. I have had a very good weekend. This has been so exciting. I can't believe that I'm here. Yeah, it's unlike anywhere that I've ever been before. I'm very tired. I actually did a good job of not drinking too much tonight. And I'm also gonna go fully sober until the marathon once I come back. I think that's probably best for training and feeling my best come marathon day. Tomorrow's gonna kind of be a little bit of a reality check coming back to Vancouver and having a full day of travel, but it's okay. I'm really glad I came here. I had the best weekend. I hope it was entertaining for y'all to watch. I am gonna have to work extra hard to not have a southern twang every time I talk. It's so fucking fun to talk with the southern accent. Anyways, thank you for watching, and I'll see y'all next week. Y'all hear that southern accent?